Hello, welcome back. Let us go to the next activity, activity number 16, that is properties of a parallelogram. But here for a change we are going to use the famous theorem which tells that the midpoints of the sides of a quadrilateral, when you join them, you will get a parallelogram. I will start with a parallelogram like that, then after getting that parallelogram we will check its properties. For that, step number 1, we will construct a quadrilateral. For that, quadrilateral means four sided figure, any 1 2 3 4 1, this is the way to construct. Now this quadrilateral is movable, you can move it in any fashion and you can move it. Well, let us take the midpoints of all the sides. You already, we have seen this idea. Midpoint means you have to either touch the two vertices of the segment or simply you touch the side. For example, midpoint, I am taking the midpoint. When I touch this side BC, midpoint obtained, midpoint obtained, midpoint obtained and midpoint obtained. Come back to this, move once again, we have to come out, you know that. Now we want one, all these sides, when you join this midpoint, when you join, you will get a parallelogram. Let us take a polygon as it starts with the EFGH. Let us start now, EFGH and E. Therefore, which you got inside, it should be a parallelogram. Now when you are moving it, the parallelogram inside is intact, it always shows the property of a parallelogram. Okay, what you can do is, now you can hide the points on the quadrilateral, you can hide it also, so that you will get the parallelogram. For that, I will go back to this graphing. Even the quadrilateral which you have drawn outside can be gone. Now this point also you can remove, 1 2 3 4, point also you can remove. Now for a parallelogram, what are the properties? The opposite sides are equal and there are certain properties of the angles also. Let us try to show these sides now. Let us go for its object property. Let us go for its value. Again go for its value. Now I am taking the value of the sides of the parallelogram. Show its value. Okay. Then show its value. Let us check whether all the values are shown here. For F it is not shown. Okay, object property. Okay, now only name is shown. Let us show the value. Okay, well, it is shown now. Let us go back to the geometry. Okay, well, now wherever you pull and push this, okay, now this opposite sides are having a property that it is 8 8 9 and 9. Let us see its angle property. Now the angle property, if you want to have an angle, the angle of this H will be obtained now, the angle G will be obtained now, this angle F will be obtained now, and the angle, sorry, go for this angle F, E and H. Sorry, let us drag it and then check it out. Okay, now you are seeing that the opposite angles are equal. The opposite angles are equal, 127, 127, 53, 53. And when you add the adjacent angle, you are getting at 180. Now this is for a particular parallelogram. Now how to get for the different parallelogram, what you have to do is, let us get back the original quadrilateral. Now it is very simple, you have to get back the quadrilateral. Now can get back the points also. We didn't remove it, it was simply hidden. Now by moving the vertices of the outside quadrilateral, you can get different parallelograms, but the property is the same. 7, 7, 7, 7. Okay, it looks like one rhombus you got. Well, now the angle also you can verify. The angle 62, 62, 118, 118. When you add them, when you add the adjacent one, and you will also base get it as 180 degrees. But remember, the thing which we have to be very careful is you cannot move this black color one because they are all midpoints. Midpoints cannot be moved. Only the vertices of the quadrilateral can be moved. Is it okay? Well, now these are the properties of the parallelogram. Is being checked by drawing the parallelogram using a property of the midpoints of a quadrilateral. Thank you, friends.